All right, folks, what's up? Rick here for CGarchitect, back with another tutorial. Ever wanted to create those Drew-worthy interior scenes you see all over the web? Well, guess what? Today's your lucky day. We're gonna break down the entire process, step by step, from concept to final render. So grab your favorite beverage, get comfy, and let's get rendering.
Every great design starts with a concept. If you're not sure where to start, let's talk about the first steps in bringing your interior scene to life. Archviz is at its strongest when it tells a story, not just shows the details. It's not unusual for artists to have to cram as much detail as possible into one single image per client's request.
That doesn't necessarily translate into an engaging image, one that truly illustrates what it's like to be there.
So, for inspiration, we're going to work with a design concept instead of a detailed project. Keep in mind that every project is different, so feel free to adapt what you see here however you like.
So, let's start with inspiration. Begin by gathering references.
Look at real interiors, focusing on design styles and details that catch your eye.
Don't overlook CG Studios' websites for cutting-edge styles, and consider using AI tools like Midjourney to generate unique reference images. One thing that helps me a lot is to collect references on Behance. I created a few mood boards and follow a ton of different studios and artists, so whenever they post something new, I can take a look at and, if I like it, save it to a mood board. Storytelling matters. We are creating an architect studio today. Think about the story you want to tell through your design. What makes this space unique? In our case, this studio will be located in an old building, like early 1900s old, formerly residential, with a very high ceiling and windows. The idea here is to portray a retrofit, showing how the studio modernized the building without losing its essence and interesting characteristics, like plaster details on the ceiling, hardwood floors, etc. It should also be a relaxed environment to foster creativity, so we'll probably have people working and interacting with each other there to illustrate this atmosphere. With your concept in hand, let's block out the basic layout in 3ds Max. Remember, start simple and refine as you go. By the way, what type of space would you like to design? Let us know in the comments.
Once your basic layout is set, it's time to breathe life into your scene.
Add details gradually, one step at a time.
Use the scene to flesh out the design ideas, focusing on making the space feel lived in and authentic.
Small details add up to creating a believable scene, so don't be afraid to let things look a little lived in. A couple of crooked pictures here and there won't hurt. One thing that really helps the image resonate with the client is having those natural imperfections, like some stains on the walls, objects and furniture that are not perfectly aligned to anything. A couple degrees won't hurt, so don't be afraid to squint your layout. Now, let's fill the studio with objects. Although there are tons of great places where you can get quality pre-made assets to populate your scenes, I find myself often returning to a few favorites. I relied on Chaos Cosmos, 3dsky.org, Design Connected, and Polygon to add everything from furniture to decor, ensuring our studio feels both professional and personal. I also have a personal library that I organize using Design Connected's connector. To be honest, I can't even remember what life was like without it. It saves me a ton of time finding the assets I need. If you don't use it already, just go grab it.
Lighting and camera setup are crucial in storytelling. Chaos Vantage rocks. It will help us preview our work in real time, enhancing our V-Ray scenes.
This tool is perfect for exploring different lighting scenarios and camera angles without the slow render times. This is real-time rendering, with ray tracing and everything. It means you can create your scene using V-Ray GPU as you normally would without having to worry. It needs you to work with V-Ray GPU so it can translate your scene correctly, so if you're not using it, it will ask you to. What I love about Vantage is that it just plugs right into your workflow. No extra work needed. There are a couple different ways to work with it, my favorite being the live link between Max and Vantage. This means you simply click a button and the software pops up and loads up your scene quickly and easily. Then you can edit elements in Max and see them instantly update in Vantage like it's a photographic viewport almost. Vantage is compatible with most V-Ray features I regularly use, including displacement. That means there's little to no disruption in my workflow when I decide to use it as a complement to V-Ray, which has been increasingly more common. Define your cameras to capture the essence of your studio. Then, adjust lighting to set the mood using atmospheric and lens effects for added drama. Once again, working with Vantage allows me to experiment a lot with different lighting options, moods, and effects. Everything is rendered on the fly, making this a creative task. The highlights here are the inbuilt physical sun sky, which I prefer to work with, click to focus, lens effects, and scattering fog features. The instant feedback makes them a real pleasure to work with, and I spend a lot of time tweaking them to get the perfect look. Once I'm happy with everything, hit render. A few comments on this workflow. Always remember you're using your GPU to render. That means you have less available memory than you're used to working with when using V-Ray CPU. Optimize your scene as much as possible using proxies and avoid those large 8K textures. You need an RTX GPU to work with Vantage. I'm using a 3080, which is really fast but doesn't have a lot of VRAM. Pay special attention to your GPU. Although really fast, this workflow is heavy on your computer, as it keeps running the whole time. Don't let your web browser and the usual 200 tabs open if you don't need to. From my experience with heavy scenes, it's best to render each camera individually instead of creating a batch. GPU memory gets full really fast, and if your GPU doesn't have a lot of RAM, weird things can happen, such as map disappearings or the frame simply not rendering at all because the system ran out of memory.
Let's add some extra polish to our render with a touch of AI and some post-production magic.
We'll use magnific.ai to boost the details in our 3D image. There's a whole tutorial on that on our channel. Check the link below. AI isn't perfect though. Sometimes it gets a little confused, like this time with this lady's head. Whoops. Or here, where it couldn't decide if someone was a man or a woman. AI, right? That's why we'll blend the original and AI-enhanced versions together, taking the best of both worlds. We'll keep the adjustments subtle to maintain realism. Fixing those little AI mistakes is easy. Just use a soft brush to erase the weird bits. Since we have a solid foundation with the original scene, the fixes blend in seamlessly. Now, just keep refining your post-processing like you normally would, and you're golden. And here it is, the big reveal, our finished Archviz Studio. Through careful planning, detailed assembly, strategic lighting, and thoughtful post-production, we've transformed this space into a lifelike scene.
Thanks for joining us on this tutorial. We hope you learned some valuable tips for creating realistic interiors with 3ds Max, V-Ray, and Vantage. We'd love to see what you create next. Share your work in our community gallery on cgarchitect.com. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tutorials from CGArchitect. Take care.